Exercise 13.12. Dismantle, clean, check, repair and assemble starter motor and starting system. Hello viewers, at the end of this exercise, you shall be able to identify the components of the starter motor, dismantle the starter motor, check the parts of the starter motor, state the type of the starting system, test the starting system under various conditions, repair armature and coil of the starter motor. Dismantling the starter motor. Disconnect the negative lead at the battery. Disconnect the magnetic switch lead wires and the battery cable from the starting motor terminals. Remove the two mounting bolts. Remove the starter motor. Removal of the magnetic switch assembly. Remove the cable terminal nut and disconnect the lead wires from the magnetic switch. Remove the two mounting nuts and then take out the magnetic switch by slight tilting as shown. Dismantling of the motor assembly. Remove the through bolts. Take off the commutator end housing. Remove the brush holder cover from the brush holder. Take out the brush spring and brush. Remove the yoke assembly. Remove the armature along with pinion drive lever. Insert the screwdriver tip in the gap between the two stop collars and push the front collar outward. Use a 14mm socket. Push the rear stop collar downwards. Pull out the rear pinion stop collar and overrunning clutch. Inspection. Magnetic switch. Inspect the magnetic switch boot for breakage. Inspect the plunger for wear or damage. Replace if necessary. Push the plunger in and release it. The plunger should return quickly to its original position. Replace it if necessary. Check for continuity across the magnetic switch's terminal and coil case. If continuity does not exist, the coil is open and should be replaced. Check for continuity across magnetic switch terminal 1 and terminal 3. If no continuity exists, the coil is open and should be replaced. Armature for ground. Using ohmmeter test for continuity between the commutator and armature core, the ohmmeter will indicate infinite resistance if the insulation is in sound condition. open circuit. Check for continuity between each pair of adjacent commutated segments using an ohmmeter. If there is any discontinuity, the ohmmeter needle will not deflect. Replace the armature assembly. Commutator runout. Place the armature between two V blocks. Using a dial gauge, check the commutator for runout by slowly rotating it by hand. Correct it on lathe if required. Commutator diameters. Check for wear and replace the armature if the diameter is below limit. Commutator surface. Clean the surface by using 400 emery cloth. Check the mica depth to a minimum of 0.2 mm and correct by using a hacksaw blade or knife if required. Check field coil. Using an ohmmeter, check for continuity between the field coil and the insulated brush. If continuity is not indicated, the insulation has failed. Replace the insulation between the brush and yoke. Brush. Measure the length of the brushes. If brushes are worn down to the service limit, replace them. Brush spring. Check the brush spring for tension, rust or breakage. Overrunning clutch. Inspect the one-way clutch for free rotation in direction A and locked up the other way round. Check the pinion for abnormal wear and replace it as assembly if required. Armature shaft and drive end cover bush. Using a 10 mm rod, take out the bush cap. Measure the internal diameter of the drive bush. Measure the outer diameter of the armature shaft at the drive end. If clearance exceeds the limit, replace the bush. Assembly. Apply grease and install the overrunning clutch to the armature shaft. Insert the rear stop collar in the armature shaft. Insert a snap ring in the armature shaft. Insert the front stop collar in the armature shaft. Apply grease to the drive lever. Combine it with armature. Assemble them with a drive hosing. Install the yoke. Install the brush holder. Install the four sets of brushes with the springs. Install the brush holder cover. Apply grease and install the commutator end hosing as shown. Replace the magnetic switch and its boot with a new one if required. Fasten the switch assembly with nuts. Connect the lead wire. Performance test. Pull-in test. Connect the test leads as shown. Check the pinion overrunning clutch jumps out. If it does not, replace it. Before testing, disconnect the field coil lead from the terminal. Hold-in test. While connecting as shown before with the pinion out, disconnect the negative lead from terminal C. Check that the pinion remains out. If not, replace the magnetic switch. Pinion return test. Disconnect the negative lead. Check to make sure that the pinion returns inward quickly. No load performance test. Connect the test leads as shown. Check the motor runs without fail with the pinion moved out. Remounting. Connect the battery cable and magnetic switch lead wires to the starter motor terminals. Place the starter motor in its position. Tighten the two mounting bolts. Connect the negative lead to the battery. In this exercise, you have learned to identify the parts of the starter motor, dismantle the starter motor, check the components of the starter motor, state the types of starting system, testing the types of starting system under various conditions, repair armature and coil of a starter motor. Exercise 13.13. Check and repair charging system components. Hello viewers, at the end of this exercise, you shall be able to list out the components of a charging system, dismantle a charging system, test the components of a charging system, identify faults in the charging system, replace the components in the charging system. The charging system consists of a rectifier unit which takes in voltage from the magneto and converts it into a DC, which is then fed to the battery through a diode through a fuse. The charging system. Remove the battery connections and loosen the positive and negative leads. Remove the fuse and the fuse wire and the coil coming out from the rectifier. Dismantle the rectifier unit by loosening the securing screws using a suitable screwdriver. Check the rectifier by allowing AC and check whether the output is unidirectional AC. If not, change the rectifier. The rectifier unit consists of diodes. Check the diodes for proper current flow direction. Check the voltage regulator for proper functioning. It should open the charging circuit when the magneto develops high voltage. Check whether the battery fuse is working properly. If not, replace the fuse. The modern charging system comes out as an electronic pack and it can only be checked but cannot be repaired. So, if there is any problem with the charging system, it has to be replaced. Battery drain test. Disconnect the negative battery terminal. Connect a 12 volts test lamp between the cable clamp and battery terminal. Ensure that every other loads are turned off. If the bulb glows, then there is a drain. Remove all the fuses one by one until the bulb is switched off. Locate the circuit and take necessary corrective action. No load voltage test. With no electrical load turned on, check the battery voltage. This is the base voltage. Now, start the engine and keep the engine at 1500 RPM. With no load other than ignition, the voltage should go up by not more than 2 volts above the base voltage. If the voltage goes up more than 2 volts, then perform an overvoltage test. Overvoltage test. Connect a jumper wire between the regulator base and magneto frame. Repeat the load test. If the overvoltage condition disappears, there is a bad circuit between the regulator and magneto. Clean the ground connections at the regulator and battery. If the overvoltage condition still exists, disconnect the regulating plug from the regulator and repeat no load test. If the overvoltage condition disappears, voltmeter reads base voltage, the regulator is defective. Replace it. If overvoltage condition still persists with regulator wiring plug disconnected, then there is a short in the wiring harness between the magneto and regulator. In this exercise, you have learned to list out the components of a charging system, dismantle the charging system, test the components of the charging system, identify faults in the charging system, replace components in the charging system. Exercise 13.14. Check voltage, continuity and resistance in electrical systems. Rectify defects in lighting systems. Hello viewers, at the end of this exercise, you shall be able to list out instruments used to measure voltage, current and resistance. Use multimeter for testing the continuity in the circuits. Use ohmmeter to find the resistance in the circuits. Use ammeter and aviometer to measure voltage, current and resistance in the circuits. Detect and rectify the fault in lighting system circuit. Checking ignition system. Check the battery terminals and tighten them if they are loose. Using a AVO meter, multimeter, in 12 voltage range, connect the positive terminals of the battery and a meter input lead to check continuity. Check continuity between a meter and ignition key and the ignition coil, magneto coil, ignition coil and distributor cap motor. Distributor outer terminal and each spark plug. There will be no distributor in motorcycles, mopeds. The spark plug will be directly connected to the HT lead to the secondary coil. If there is any discontinuity between any of the shown circuit, the multimeter will show very high, infinite resistance, indicating broken or loose connection between points. Sometimes, the wires may be broken or torn, which may lead to discontinuity. If there is any open circuit, replace the defective leads. Also, tighten any loose connections. Checking voltage in the coil ignition circuit magneto assembly. Check the connectivity between battery and CDI capacitor ignition circuit unit using a multimeter and check for any faults like discontinuity, open connections. Check the connectivity between voltage regulator, charging rectifier and diode system and the battery. Ensure that the battery is not overchanged or underchanged. Check the resistance between voltage regulator and magneto assembly using a correct range of ohmmeter. If the test lamp lights or ohmmeter reading is almost zero, then the circuit is grounded. Rectify it. Using a digital multimeter, DMM, check the continuity for each wiring circuit like horn, headlight, tail lamp, brake light switch circuit, etc. And take suitable corrective action. If the bulb filament is worn out, replace the bulb in the respective circuit. If the bulb is working well, then check for any discontinuity or short in the circuit and rectify it. Owner's manual, service manual of any two-wheelers will contain the detailed wiring circuit or diagram. Refer the diagram and carry out the electrical checks. Lighting system circuit and fault finding procedure. The lighting system provides illumination on the road to ensure good visibility for the driver, safety to the vehicle and the vehicle coming on the opposite direction, and also as a safety device for the following vehicles. The headlamp, tail lamp, brake light, turn signal lights, flasher, speedometer console light and warning light constitute the lighting system. The lighting system consists of switches, lamps, wiring harness and fuse. Fault finding procedure in lighting system circuit. The lighting system circuit of moped is as shown. Check each circuit, headlamp, brake light, tail lamp, turn signal indicator and speedometer console for continuity using a digital multimeter. Check for worn out bulbs, tail lamp, headlight, turn signal indicator, speedometer console light. If the bulb is fused, then replace it with a new one of the same specification. Care should be taken while handling replacing halogen bulbs. They should not be touched by hands. It may explode as it contains gas. If the bulb is in good condition, then check for any loose wiring connections or pin or socket. Tighten them. Check for any short in wiring. If found any, replace it and suitably wind insulation tape over the wire. In this exercise, you have learned to list out the instruments used to measure voltage, current and resistance. Use multimeter for testing the continuity in the circuit. Use ohmmeter to find the resistance in the circuits. Use ammeter and aviometer to measure the voltage, current and resistance in the circuits. Detect and rectify the fault in lighting system circuits. Exercise 13.15. Check battery condition, prepare electrolyte, top up and maintain battery. Hello viewers, at the end of this exercise, you shall be able to check the condition of a battery, prepare electrolyte, use hydrometer to check specific gravity, charge the battery, list out methods of charging, state precautions followed while charging a battery. The amount of current a battery can deliver depends on total area and volume of the active plate material and strength of the electrolyte. Testing of battery. Disconnect the cables from the battery. Remove the clamp nuts. Clean the battery with a neat cotton rag and water. Clean the battery terminals with a non-metallic wire brush or emery paper. Check the specific gravity of the battery with the help of a hydrometer. Place the battery on a level surface and open the vent plugs. Hold the hydrometer vertically. Place the nose of the hydrometer in each cell. Press the hose and release it to draw the electrolyte to check the specific gravity. Note down the specific gravity value. Preparation of electrolyte. Take about 64 ml of distilled water in a beaker. Take about 36 ml of concentrated sulfuric acid in another beaker. Add the sulfuric acid to the beaker containing water. Care should be taken not to pour water to sulfuric acid as it may increase the temperature and the mixture may explode due to liberation of large amount of heat. Also, sulfuric acid is very corrosive and may cause serious burns if it comes into contact with skin. Use suitable protective devices like goggles, acid-proof funnel while preparing the electrolyte. Now, the electrolyte is ready and it should be added to an empty battery, lead battery shell without electrolyte, and kept under charging condition. Specific gravity of water is 1 and specific gravity of sulfuric acid 36% is 1.835. As such, the specific gravity of final electrolyte should be 1.27, which is to be tested with a hydrometer. Check the electrolyte level of the battery. Charging the battery with low electrolyte level may damage it. Charging the battery with high electrolyte level may cause overflow of electrolyte due to gassing and heat. Battery can be charged quickly or slowly. Connect the positive terminals of the battery to the positive terminal of the charger. Connect the negative terminal of the battery to the negative terminal of the charger. Ensure that the connections are tight to avoid sparking. Switch on the battery charger. The charging may be under constant voltage or current condition. If the charge indicator of a maintenance-free battery shows yellow or no color, then do not charge it as the electrolyte level is low. Discard the battery. Check the temperature and specific gravity of the battery periodically during charging. if the temperature goes beyond 125 degree Fahrenheit, 51.7 degree Celsius, stop the charge. The battery is fully charged when the specific gravity remains constant for 3 hours, and also the cells should be gassing freely. A load resistance of 3 times the battery ampere hour capacity is placed on the battery. If the voltage at the end of 15 seconds read 9.6 voltage or higher than the battery is good. If the voltage at the end of 15 seconds is less than 9.6 voltage, then test the specific gravity of each cell. If the difference between 2 cells is more than 50 points, then the battery has to be replaced. Maintenance of battery. Battery is an expensive item to be replaced. If maintained properly, it would last for a longer period. The following aspects of battery are to be checked to maintain the battery in good condition. Check and top up the electrolyte level every week. Electrolyte should be 10 to 15 millimeter above the plates. Check the specific gravity of the battery periodically with the help of a hydrometer. If the specific gravity falls below 1.18, add a few drops of sulfuric acid. In this exercise, you have learned to check the condition of a battery, prepare electrolyte, use hydrometer to check specific gravity, charge the battery, list out methods of charging, state precautions followed while charging a battery. Exercise 13.16. Check speedometer and rectify the defect. Hello viewers, at the end of this exercise, you shall be able to identify the components in the speedometer system, lubricate the gears in the speedometer system, replace worn out gears and speedometer cable. The speedometer consists of a cable attached to the front wheel through a worm wheel arrangement. When the wheel rotates, the worm wheel rotates and rotates the worm, which connects the cable, and the speedometer moves proportional to the speed of rotation of worm. Rotate the front wheel in the forward direction. If the speedometer moves to a few distance, then it is all right. If the speedometer is not moving, then check the cable. The cables might be loose. Tighten them both near the speedometer end and the front wheel end. Loosen the speedometer cable from the front wheel and rotate the worm wheel. If the worm rotates, then the cable is the problem. Replace the cable. If the worm gear is worn out, then the speedometer will oscillate. Replace the gear arrangement. Lubricate the gears and the cable. In this exercise, you have learned to identify the components in the speedometer system, lubricate the gears in the speedometer system, replace worn out gears and speedometer cable. Exercise 13.17. Do fine-tuning and test the vehicle. Hello viewers, at the end of this exercise, you shall be able to adjust carburetor for optimum engine performance, set ignition timing, clean spark plug and ignition sap, check brake and clutch functioning, check the battery, adjust settings for better performance, identify engine problem and remedy. Tuning and test the vehicle. Take a road test of the vehicle about 2 kilometers. Ensure the acceleration is good and smooth. Ensure that the firing is smooth. Timing to be checked if engine misfires. Check whether the brake and the suspension are functioning properly. Adjust the brake ply to required level. Adjust the clutch lever so that the engage and disengage is smooth. Check whether all the instruments in the console are functioning properly. Headlight, tail lamp and brake light, left and right blinkers. Adjust the chain if the ply is large and adjustment is necessary. Tune the carburetor for correct idling condition and adjust the idling screw suitably. Check the ignition timing once again and take corrective action if necessary. Ensure that all the engine bolts are tightened to require torque using torque wrench. If there are any over or under tightened bolts, it may lead to vibration and stress and the bolt may fail prematurely. Properly inflate the tire 25 psi for the front and 29 psi for the rear, solo, and 27 psi and 32 psi with pillion rider. Refer to service manual for recommended tire pressure for each vehicle. Check the battery for electrolyte level and proper current rating. Also check the specific gravity of the battery and ensure it is satisfactory. In this exercise, you have learned to adjust the carburetor for optimum engine performance, set ignition timing, clean spark plug and reset sap, check the brake and clutch functioning, check the battery, adjust the settings for better performance, identify the engine problems and their remedies. Thank you.
This video instructional. Today the program is repair and overhauling of two-wheeler motorcycles. This video programming is a supporting material for your textbook. Before you begin each exercise, please study the related theory given in the textbook. Exercise 15.01. water wash and clean the vehicles. At the end of this exercise, you shall be able to understand the following tasks. Identify the parts of the vehicle. Wash different types of vehicle. List out the precaution to be followed while water washing. Use water pump and adjust pressure setting.
Place the vehicle in the washing pit line. Keep the vehicle on a flat, rigid surface or put the vehicle in center stand. Take proper precaution to cover up electrical equipments like switch, relays. Remove the battery and keep it under charging under recommended conditions. Switch on the pump and set the recommended pressure as specified in the service manual by adjusting the nozzle opening and checking the pressure in the pressure gauge. Use soap or mild detergent for cleaning. Use a medium pressure of water jet. Clean the vehicle thoroughly, keeping it upright. Then, keep vehicle resting on the ground with a suitable support, a tire as a cushion. Clean all the external parts, which might be difficult if the vehicle is with stand. Switch off the pump. Again, keep the vehicle upright and allow the water to drain. And move to the service lane. Then use compressed air to clean trapped water. Spray any suitable anti-corrosive liquid over the vehicle to minimize rust formation. Wipe the vehicle with a clean soft cloth thoroughly. Care to be taken not to damage the body painting. Lubricate the brake, clutch and the drive chain. Fit the battery. Start the vehicle just to ensure engine is working.
Exercise 15.02. Remove broken stuff. Students, at the end of this exercise, you shall be able to understand the following tasks. Remove the broken parts of the vehicle. Identify the tools for removing the broken stuff. Finish a broken stud for removing by drilling. Move a broken stud using tap. Remove a broken stud using easy extractor.
Remove broken stud. The stud is used in place of a bolt, where a hole cannot be had for the bolt to pass through, or to avoid the use of an unnecessary long bolt. Studs are generally used to fix up cover plates or to connect cylinder covers to engine covers. Procedure: to remove stud below the surface, file flat on the top surface of the stud. Locate the center and center punch it. Select the easy out and the recommended drill size from table 1. Drill a hole on the center punch mark. Ensure the hole is perpendicular. Set the easy out stud extractor on the drilled hole. Turn it anti-clockwise by a tap wrench. As the easy out penetrates into the stud, the grip increases and gradually the broken stud portion unscrews. Replace a new stud in position after lubricating the threads, making drill hole. Correctly find out the center of the broken stud and drill a hole of diameter little less than the core diameter of the stud down the center so that the threads only remain. Remove the thread portion by the point of a scriber in the form of broken chips. Re-tap the drilled hole to clear the threads. Pick punch method. If the stud is broken very near to the surface, drive it in an anti-clockwise direction using a hammer and a center punch to remove it. Removing broken stud above the surface. File two sides of the studs flat above the surface. Use a wrench and unscrew to remove the broken stud out. To remove the broken stud or bolt below the surface, locate the center of the broken stud. Center punch it. Drill in the center of the broken stud by using a drill of diameter little less than the root diameter of the thread on stud. Use the right easy out number of the extractor. Turn the extractor to force out the broken part of the stud. If all other methods fail, drill a hole equal to the size of the stud size and tap the hole with an oversized tap. Now, a special oversized stud, as shown, is to be made and fitted in position. Recommended drill and easy out size for the extraction of broken stud and bolt. Suitable for screw size. Drill size to be used. Easy out number to be used. 1x8 inch to 1x4 inch. 3 to 6 millimeter. 5x64 inch. 2 millimeter. 1/4 inch to 5x16 inch. 6 to 8 millimeter. 7x64 inch. 2.8 millimeter. 2/5x16 inch to 7x16 inch. 8 to 11 millimeter. 5x32 inch. 2 millimeter. 3/7x16 inch to 9x16 inch. 11 to 14 millimeters. 1x4 inch. 6.3 millimeters. 4/9x16 inch to 3x4 inch. 14 to 19 millimeters. 17x64 inch. 6.7 millimeters.
Clean, check, fuel tank. Students, at the end of this exercise, you shall be able to understand the following tasks. There is different types of leakage in fuel tank. Overhaul a fuel tank and repaint it.
Task 1. Park the vehicle on a flat surface. Close the fuel tap. Remove fuel pipeline from fuel filter and drain the fuel in the tank into a clean container by opening the fuel tap. Use compressed air to remove the last traces of fuel. The fuel tank is secured to the chassis with bolts and nuts. Use appropriate size double end or ring spanner to remove the bolt and nut. Task 2. Remove fuel tank cap and pipeline. Clean them and blow out compressed air on tank or pipelines. Visually inspect the tank for any dent or corrosion. If corrosion is not attended to, the tank will develop leakage in future. Check fuel tap for blockage or leakage. refit. Inspect the fuel lines for broken or damaged portion. Damaged fuel lines may lead to leakage of fuel. Replace the old fuel line if found worn or weaned out by a quality line of suitable size. Task 3. Fit the fuel tank using the previously used spanner. Align it to the required torque range using torque wrench. Fill fuel. Open tap and examine for leakages, etc. and take corrective action.
Dismantle, clean, check engine component and assemble. At the end of this exercise, you shall be able to understand the following tasks. Identify various engine parts. Identify the procedure. Dismantle various engine components. Identify the precautions to be followed while overhauling an engine. Check various engine parts using instrument and gauges. Assemble various parts of engine using proper tools. Clean the different engine components.
Dismantling the engine. Park the vehicle on a flat surface rigidly by keeping the vehicle on the center stand. Close the fuel tap. Also, remove the battery and its connections from the battery holder using suitable screwdriver. Remove the carburetor by loosening the air filter hose and inlet manifold connection. Dismantle the chain from the sprocket using suitable plier or snip tool. Remove the clutch cable by loosening the lock nut. Drain the engine oil by loosening the drain nut or plug. Remove the spark plug from the cylinder head using a plug spanner. Dismantle the cylinder head from the crank case by loosening the bolts provided on the cylinder head. Remove the intake and exhaust valve along with the valve seating and spring. Remove the cylinder head gaskets and bushes and keep it in a safe, clean place. Take out the cotters, locks, collets using the special tool. Care should be taken not to change the timing or damage identification marks. Loosen the connecting rod bolts from the big end of the crankshaft using suitable DE spanner. Remove the brass bushes from the connecting rod. Remove the piston pin by gently tapping on the pin and dismantle piston from the connecting rod. Remove the piston ring from the piston using a circlip plier. Separate the crankshaft gear from the countershaft gear. Crankshaft using suitable DE spanner and also the bearings using suitable pullers. Remove the flywheel, securing bolts from the crankshaft using suitable DE spanner. Dismantle the flywheel. Remove the lube oil pump and clean it separately. Cleaning. Clean the piston head thoroughly, removing the carbon and other deposits on it. Clean the inlet and exhaust valves. Also clean the valve springs and seating. The crankshaft thoroughly with recommended solvent, removing any carbon oil deposits with a wire brush. Clean the various bolts and nuts fitted on the cylinder head and crankcase thoroughly. Clean the cylinder walls thoroughly. Check engine components or inspection. Check the face of the flywheel with the help of a dial indicator. Check the flywheel teeth for braking or pitting. Check the valves, valve spring and valve seating for any pitting or crack. Check the piston connecting rod and the piston pin. Inspect the flywheel crankshaft, camshaft and timing gears, sprocket and chain. Check the cylinder walls and liner for any crack or pitting. Assemble. Clean the bore of the cylinder and place the main bearing. Ensure that the oil holes are aligned. Install the crankshaft rear bearing seal. Install the thrust washers to the respective bearings. Crankshaft in its position in the cylinder. Place the shell bearing into the respective bearing caps. Check the bearing liners or shells for spread. The inserts should snap into position in the housing cap. Bolts of the bearing cap to specified torque and check the crankshaft for free rotation. Fit the ring gear on the flywheel. Align the flywheel dowel pins with dowel pins on the flange. Thank you. preventing it from rotation and tighten the bolts or nuts diagonally using torque wrench. The piston pin, piston, and connecting rod. Cylinder head using the bolts and tighten the bolts using torque wrench to specified torque. Assemble the valve, valve guidance, valve spring, and the seating. Fix the spark plug and tighten using torque wrench to specified torque. Crankcase with recommended lube oil. Attach the carburetor. And various other cable linkages like choke, throttle, etc. And check for any unwanted noise or sound.
Namaste friends, today we have Mr. D.N. Sharma with us who will show us how to use the UPI service. UPI, which is known as Unified Payment Interface, through this service we